Good evening. I'm pleased to be here with Chris Rodier. And Chris is a photographer. And his work is behind us, and it's some spectacular stuff. And I hope you get an opportunity to come down to the Clayton Center and see it this month. Chris, pleased to meet you.
Nice
Thank
to meet
you
there.
For joining us tonight.
Thank you for having me.
And you have some beautiful work here.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about yourself. Where did you grow up?
Well, I grew up in Florida, and grew up Palm Bay, Florida, which is just south of Cape Canaveral. Grew up there my high school years, and then from there I went to in the Air Force. Went to Alaska for my first tour.
I saw some of your pictures, I think, are
yes,
from Alaska. Beautiful stuff.
Yes, sir. Yeah, thank you. Yes.
So have you always been interested in photography, or was that something you picked up when you were in the service?
Pretty much when I actually picked up a little bit in high school, a senior, I got a little taste of it when I was in class and taking courses at Palm Bay High School. And then from there, when I went to Alaska and saw the mountains, and it was just, it was unbelievable with all the beauty. I was like, got to get a camera, and because I'll never know if I'll come back. So,
where were you stationed up there? Were you in a nice place, or were you
yes.
out in some bunker?
I was in Anchorage, which is beautiful.
Oh, yeah,
yeah, Anchorage, Alaska, Elwendorf Air Force Base, which
I've
is
been to
it was great.
It is
great, and
so you make it up into Denali very often?
Once, and got close enough to see Mount McKinley and take some photos but you never did any camping there. But I heard it's really nice.
I don't know if I'd want to camp there. We were in the park for less than an hour. We saw grizzly bears, moose, the Denali sheep, and all
yes.
that kind of stuff. And,
yes.
There's a lot of wildlife out there. I don't think I'd want to sleep out
no,
there.
No, they used to have tours. I don't know if they still do, where they take you out, but I didn't try it. So. Yeah.
How long were you in the Air Force?
Almost 8 years. Mm-hmm. And I got out in 1992, and went back to school and started doing photography, learning about all the photography along the way, and taking some classes and learning how to develop as well as take photos. So I have.
But photography is not your primary occupation.
No, I'm a telecommunications analyst at First Citizens Bank. And I work at their data center, and that's my day job. And nights and weekends are my freelance work.
Okay. You currently live over in Flowers Plantation, is that correct?
Yes, sir.
And apparently you're doing some work for money.
Yes, sir.
I mean, people are hiring you to do photography.
Yes, and doing some portrait work for some friends. I'm also do some freelance for Clayton New Star, as well as, I do a lot of sports photography, high school.
Yes, you have a lot of sports photography
That's just a little thumbnail of what I have, but I do, I'm also a freelance for Icon Sports Media, and I do a lot of ACC football and basketball as well.
You're busy with this, aren't you?
Yes, sir, and then when the weekends, and I'm not shooting at a game, I'm usually taking a short tour around and seeing what our city and county offers as well as far as scenery, which we have a lot of.
You have about maybe 10 pieces here.
Yes, sir.
That are on canvas.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about that process. I mean, it's a wonderful concept. When you look at it, it almost looks like a painting.
Yes, sir. It's got a little bit of texture to it, and I try to reserve it more for my landscapes, to give it more. I think it brings out a little bit of sometimes it brings out the color, brings out some more of the techniques that I makes it a little bit more of a painting. Whereas some of the prints, offer some as well, different mm-hmm. things. But people look and it almost is it a painting because it's on canvas?
Exactly.
So I'm trying it out and see how some folks, they still like the print, which is fine.
I think it's a great concept. The texture just looks a little bit different, and it's very nice. You have a lighthouse over there, or you're
yes,
looking
sir.
Straight up into the clouds. That is a spectacular picture. And
thank you.
I'm sure we'll show it on the show tonight.
Thank you.
But how did you get that? You had to be
tripod.
Just the right type. Tripod? Okay.
tripod.
Otherwise you'd fall over.
Yeah, tripod and and just a lot of tweaking and with my camera, I was doing some different techniques with my ISO settings and shutter and trying to bring out a little bit more color and bring out the clouds. I mean, so when I go back to post-production, I can bring out the clouds. So.
Well, it's a wonderful show, and we're happy that you joined us. Are you showing anywhere on a regular basis?
Not yet. I hope to in the near future.
Okay, well, let us know, and we'll put it on our website and try to help you along with that.
Well, thank you. I appreciate it.
Well, thank you again.
Thank you, sir.
And
appreciate it.
We're going to have a wonderful show here tonight, and I hope people will get down here to see it this month.
Thank you.
I'm here with Elizabeth de Sherbinin. Elizabeth D. Sherbinin.
Correct.
It's a mouthful.
It is.
Elizabeth, thank you for showing your work tonight. It's absolutely beautiful.
Thank you.
Let's talk a little bit about your beginning.
Okay.
You grew up here in the area?
I grew up in Raleigh, and I've lived different places, but in 1990, we moved to Johnston County and lived here for 20 years. Mm-hmm.
And it was while you were living in Johnston County that you got the art bug, is that right?
Right. Ramona Cash and I started taking art classes together.
Is that right?
And she still paints with me.
That's wonderful. So, Ramona's a wonderful lady.
She is.
And I know you were in the women's club.
I was.
And but you've moved away.
I did.
Not too far away.
Just to Raleigh. It's not too far.
No, it's not too far. Well, tell me how you got started.
I have a twin sister. She majored in art, and I kept trying her to start art classes again.
Uh-huh.
And she wasn't interested at the time. I said, I think I'll start taking some classes, and that's what happened. Ramona and I
both started with pen and ink or colored pencils?
Well, pencil, and then colored pencil, and then we did watercolor, and then we did a little bit of pastels. And then we tried acrylics, and that's when I knew I had found my medium. And now I do water-soluble oils on top of acrylic.
I read that in your bio, and I didn't quite understand that. You paint a canvas and kind of seal it.
No, what I do is I use the acrylic paint to get me started. It's something about, it's a way to motivate me, and I can just do a real rough, quick underneath.
And then you fill in.
And sometimes I let a lot of that color shine through, and I don't cover it up. And then sometimes it gets completely covered up by those oils. So it just depends. It gets me going.
Well, your work is beautiful.
Thank you.
I think you love clouds.
I do. I love skies. I have a lot of skies.
Some beautiful paintings over there and magnificent skies.
Thank you.
The thing that I liked about your work is if you're really up close to it, it's kind of impressionistic.
Yes.
But then when you back up, it looks like a picture hanging over there. It's beautiful work.
Thank
it's
you.
Really nice.
Thank you.
Tell me a little bit more about the process. Does that take longer to dry that way when you're...
Well, the acrylic dries very fast, and water-soluble oils dry much faster than oils. And I like the water soluble because I can't take the smell of regular oils. But the oils blend a little bit better, in my opinion, than the acrylics. So I use both.
Well, that's a wonderful technique. Do you have a show anywhere? Are you hanging regularly?
I had a show in last September at the Johnston County Community College at their Frank Creech Gallery.
Oh, yes.
And this is another one, so it's a matter of, it's a lot of work to do this. I'd rather be painting.
I was with the Johns County Arts Council when we put that gallery together down there, and we were pretty proud of the fact that of all the community colleges in North Carolina, that is the only one with a gallery.
It's beautiful. The lighting's wonderful.
And Frank
there.
Creech was such a wonderful, wonderful man. So anyway, you were down there in September. You have anything else coming up in the near future?
Not yet.
Yeah.
No, it's just kind of, I just look around. It's a lot of work. I'd rather be painting, as I said.
Okay.
So.
Well, I appreciate you coming out.
Thank you so much.
And joining us. And I appreciate you talking to me tonight.
Thank you.
Most artists don't like to talk, but you did just fine.
Thank you.
Wonderful evening again at the Clayton Center. The art is beautiful, and we're just having a grand time. We hope you come down and join us. We have refreshments every time we do this. And when do we do it? We do it the first Thursday of every month. Next month, it's going to be Thursday, March 6th. And we have two artists again next month. Michael Morrison, who a lot of the local people will know. And he's a painter. He generally paints in oil. And then we have Katie Prost, and she's a photographer. So just like this month, we have one painter and one photographer.